Hello everyone, and welcome to another edition of the Hornet Report. Well, 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 it's that time of year where the holidays are in the rear view and the awesome warm weather in spring is a bit of a trek away. In the meantime, we're here to bring you some fun even with the lack of sun. Beside me today is Faith Wareham, who has a rundown on today's stories. Faith?
Thanks, Carlee. Hi everyone, I'm Faith Wareham, and just as Carlee had said, we have some awesome stories for you today. First up, Chef Harkness presented his annual pizza contest, which really pushes the limits. Does venison really belong on pizza? And what about fig jam? Arielle Borges, Gianna Rutigliano, and Tony Salerno were there to answer those questions. Next, Ben Sammut has all the buzz in Holmdel sports, including special features on the girls and boys basketball teams. Finally, Anna Dounis will be asking HHS students, do you really have any New Year's resolutions? And who's actually stuck to them? But up first, here's the rundown on HHS's annual pizza contest.
This is just Korean fried chicken with spicy red pepper sauce and topped with mozzarella cheese.
Do you think you're gonna win?
I don't know.
We don't know yet.
Okay.
But like possibly.
My name is Matt Robbins.
What pizza are you making?
I am making the Reuben pizza. Here we have our pulled pork, our Thousand Island dressings right here. This is our dough. We have caraway seeds in it and all black pepper. Crispy fried onions, this is gonna be our garnish. Right over here is our sauerkraut, this is also going on the pizza. And over there is our cheese, that is our Swiss cheese.
The point was to bring a little bit of this room, the energy and the excitement of the pizza contest to the audience via FaceTime.
And it smells fabulous.
If we hit it off, it's a flavor appearance.
Do you think you're gonna win?
Oh yeah, of course, I'm always gonna win.
Hi, I'm Shane Morris, and we're doing a smokehouse venison pizza. We're doing a quick pickle red onion. We're doing a pepper seared venison as well, with some Asiago and Gouda. And that about tops it off with a smoky tomato sauce. I think we got a good chance.
Chef, you would be proud of them. You would be so proud of them, Chef. They're doing awesome here. They're thinking of everything that you taught them, and they're working and making this pizza fabulous.
Hi, I'm Mr. Dow.
How do you think the pizza contest went this year?
As always, it goes like it goes, and I think we had a great time tonight. We have over 100 people here tonight, including donations that were made for people who couldn't show up. I had all the proceeds go tonight to my son Jack Dow's scholarship fund, which goes to a graduating senior or seniors at the end of the year at the award ceremony, $1,000 to them.
I'm JV Lopez. I was judging the 2022 pizza contest.
What are your qualifications?
I participated in the pizza contest as a freshman. I judged it as a sophomore, and I have a brick oven pizza in my backyard.
What was your favorite pizza?
My favorite pizza was the buffalo chicken, which, believe it or not, had the least creativity but best other features.
I think people enjoyed the pizzas. I think the audience was in a great mood tonight. I think the people that cooked the pizzas and prepared the pizzas were great. And I want to take a moment to just thank staff and students and everybody that pitched in at the last minute to kind of help out.
I'm so happy to win. I really did not expect this. Gotta thank my team for this one.
From the beginning of this day, which turned out a little disastrous and very sad, it really wound up very nice and very fun and very uplifting.
Thanks everyone, and congrats to all the contestants on bringing your creative pizzas to the big stage. Well, Ben, it's time. Bring on the sports. I know I'm ready, but the question is, are you?
Yes, Carlee, I was born ready. Winter sports are often running, swimming, and wrestling. The girls' swim team won their recent meet against Rani 108-57, improving their record to 2-3. The girls' basketball team has had a very impressive season so far, as they're once again ranked in the top 10 in the Shore Conference. Arielle Borges and Ryan Lopez met up with the girls to talk about their success.
I think
think that our strengths are that we have really good chemistry and that we're all like friends outside of basketball, so it kind of makes it easy for us to play good and win.
I think one of our biggest strengths is that we always have good energy and are very supportive of each other.
I think our strengths are that we always bring effort and we bring passion to the game every single time we play. I think no matter who we're up against, we always have fire in our belly and we're always showing our effort and our strength.
Goals for the rest of the season?
I think definitely just playing as best as we can every game and winning, of course.
Thanks, guys. And congrats to the girls on their recent win against Haddon Heights, 60-50. It was Haddon Heights' first loss of the season. In other sports news, the boys' basketball team was supposed to be rebuilding this season. Instead, the boys have turned some heads in the short conference with some big wins. Here's Lainie Doran with the story.
Thanks, Ben. This year, the boys' basketball team is mostly made up of underclassmen. I had the opportunity to interview some of these starting sophomores and freshmen. Let's see if they are handling the pressure of performing on the varsity team.
Nick, you had a career high of 29 points in the victory over Toms River North. How do you plan to improve from here?
Oh, we got to get better in practice every day, work hard, and get it done every day.
What are some team goals for the season?
We got to stick to our culture, work hard, don't stop till the whistle blows, play for 32 minutes, and play as a team.
How would you like to see the team improve?
We need to improve as a team. We need to work way harder than we do now. We need to hit the box. Gotta get in the glass more and execute our plays.
Tie game against Shore Regional, 3 seconds left to break the tie, and you made a three-pointer to win the game. How did you feel in that moment?
I just saw my teammate get the ball, drive to the basket, and I saw him kick it out. And when I saw the ball drop into my hands, and I just felt confident, stepped into it, and I shot, and I just saw the ball go in, and it was just a great moment for me and my team.
What are some team goals for the season?
Knowing that team, we had a big team last year. We had a COVID year, which was kind of hard, but we got a lot of seniors last year to kind of help us out and teach us the ways. And we have a new team this year, and we're trying our best just to learn from Devaney and learn what we can do together as a team.
How would you like to see the team improve this season?
Chemistry-wise, I want to see us be able to play with each other, know each other's weaknesses and strengths, and just be able to play with each other and have a fun time on the court. That's all it is about basketball, having fun.
How does it feel to be the only freshman on varsity?
It's a big adjustment from last year playing with the 8th graders, and I'm learning a lot from the older kids.
What are some goals you have for the next 4 seasons playing for the Hornets?
For the next 4 seasons, I just want to get better and try and win a state championship with the team.
What are some team goals for the season?
I think we need to play better defense and work together as a whole and just have better chemistry.
How much confidence does the team have going into the rest of the season?
I think we have a lot of confidence. We're really young, but we know we can all fit in and accomplish many goals that other people think we can't accomplish.
Which a lot of great senior players graduated last year. How are you feeling going into the season with such a young team?
We always have high expectations here. We did lose a lot last year, but we like to think our program's pretty strong, and every year we go in, we expect to be really, really competitive, and this year's no different.
What are some goals the team has set for the season?
We're a little different. We only really set goals for ourselves in terms of how good we can be. We need to play as a team, and we need to really, really learn how to play with a great effort. And if we can do those two things, you know, the postseason tournaments seem to take care of their own.
With a team made up of so many sophomores, what are you looking forward to for the next few seasons?
We just need to get better, and that starts with me. As a coach, I need to get better, the kids need to get better, and all of us have to work hard to get better individually, so we'll be better as a team, and we have to learn how to play as a team.
How would you like to see the team improve?
Well, the coaching would probably be a good start. We need better coaching, and we just need to be more consistent. It's a 32-minute game, and we have to keep fighting for 32 minutes.
How have the underclassmen been able to mature so quickly?
Well, some of them played last year. They played a lot of basketball, just not at this level. So it's really just a matter of getting used to the physicality and the speed. Those are the two biggest things when kids aren't used to varsity level. And we've played an unbelievably hard schedule so far. So we've really raised the bar in terms of how difficult our schedule is. But I think they're adapting pretty well. And after 9 games now, we should be pretty much settled into how we're going to play.
The boys have won 7 of their first 12 games, and the underclassmen are excited for the future of the team. Good luck with the rest of the season.
Thanks, Lainie, and great win over Middletown South. Keep it up. In other sports news, boys swimming is undefeated and finished 2nd in the Monmouth County Championships. It's their best finish in 10 years. Last, but certainly not least, the wrestling team beat Keyport 60-12, improving their record to 7-8. Way to go, Hornets. Keep up all the great work. I'm Ben Sammut, and that's The Buzz in Holmdel Sports.
Thanks, Ben. Great job, Hornets. In other news, with January coming to an end, it's time to look back on the first month of 2022. Did you make a New Year's resolution? And if you did, were you able to stick to it? Anna Dounis went around HHS in search of some answers.
Thanks, guys. Today I walked around Holmdel High School asking people about their New Year's resolutions and what keeps them motivated to stick to their goals. Let's see on what they have to say. What were your New Year's resolutions for this year?
My New Year's resolution for this year is to continue having positive energy and positive attitude and being kind to others and to continue doing good at school and to continue doing what I love, which is singing, dancing, acting, and just being myself.
My New Year's resolutions for this year are probably to sleep more because I'm not really getting enough sleep and I feel like it's affecting my grades, my mental health, so I want to try to sleep more and prioritize myself a little bit.
They're pretty simple. I just want to get good grades and do well in all the sports I'm doing.
What kind of sports are you planning to do this year?
I'm doing track, cross country, and right now I'm doing swimming.
What are your New Year's resolutions for this year?
To be a better person.
Why do you want to be a better person?
Because I feel like I'm a bad person.
Mine is for the Jets to win the Super Bowl, and his team were solid, right?
What makes you think the Jets are going to win?
We got Zach Wilson. He's the best QB to do it. That's all I got to say.
I don't have any resolutions. I've kind of been put on the spot real quick.
New Year's resolutions. I am going to I'm going to try running.
I have a lot of New Year's resolutions. First of all, I'm trying to get more handy because I'm going to work at Patricia's this coming summer.
What motivates me the most is definitely my family and friends, and this year I joined the HTG, and everyone's just a big family, and everyone just motivates each other, so that definitely motivates me to continue doing what I do.
What makes you want to do running?
Because it's something that I don't enjoy doing at all, and I think it's important to stay healthy, and I know it's the winter now, but I think it's something you could start indoors, and then when it's time for spring, maybe be in a better position to go run outdoors, enjoy the nice weather.
The reason why I want to stick to my New Year's resolution this year is because I'm going to work this summer, and I need to, and I want to become like a busboy because I have a friend that owns Patricia's, Frankie Brusco, and I just want to be like a good employee.
If you had some goals for this year, what would it be?
To have a New Year's resolution. That'd be probably one of my goals.
Why do you not want to be a bad person anymore?
Because nobody likes bad people.
All right, thank you so much.
Bye!
It was incredible hearing about different people's New Year's aspirations and how much they want to improve themselves during the new year. Thanks for watching. Back to you at the studio.
Thanks, Anna. Wow, a lot of interesting resolutions there. I would have to say that my resolution of giving Ben a nice big head rub every day has become null and void. How are you doing on your New Year's resolution, Faith? Honestly, Carlee, my New Year's resolution was to help Ben write a better script for the Hornet Report. So far, little success, but there's always room for improvement, right?
Guys, I'm standing right here.
Get over here, buddy!
Come on!
We can keep working on your
solution.
I think this is where you can improve. Definitely just cut that out. That's embarrassing.
True.
Don't say that again.
Yes.
Keep going.
For future reference,
great.
I wouldn't say that.
So. I think we're ready for you to go. You're kind of shedding.
All right, bye, Ben.
Let's take it away. All right, well, that's the end of this episode, but to stay in the know with our HHS Hornet Report crew, like our New Year's resolutions and Ben's head, follow us on our social media. Our Twitter and Instagram are at HHS Hornet Report, and our Snapchat is at Hornet Report. And always remember, guys, join us next time where we'll bring you this week's best at HHS. No, that was so good!